What's up mga kap and welcome to When in Halifax. On this video, I'm going to give some updates of what is happening here in Canada. Last March 16 mga kap, our Prime Minister here in Canada announced about the travel restrictions. Ano yung travel restriction na nirelease nila? Number one, the travel restriction is only Canadian citizens and permanent residents are allowed to enter Canada. So sila lang po yung pwedeng pumasok dito sa Canada. Actually, we have kap or kapatid natin na hindi sila nakapasok sa Canada because of these travel restrictions. If you want to watch the full interview of Farah and Denise wherein nakalabas sila ng Pilipinas, nakapunta sila ng Japan, pero pagdating sa Japan to Canada, pinauwi sila sa Pilipinas because of this travel restriction. So if you want to watch the full interview of our East Coast Filipino family, I'll post the link on the description below. Click the link and watch the interview and you will know what happened to Denise and Farah. But anyway, mga kap, on this video, we have a good news for you. So if you are a COPR holder, if you have a approved work permit or you have an approved student permit, as of today, March 27, you can now enter Canada, mga kap. So I'm going to read the advisory quote by quote. First is temporary foreign workers, some international students, and approved permanent residents who haven't yet landed are now able to enter Canada. So student, work permit, and permanent COPR or permanent resident are now allowed to enter Canada. So good news mga kap. So if you are currently holding a COPR, if you're holding a student permit, you're holding a work permit visa, mga kap, you can now enter Canada. Pero mga kap, there's a restrictions. So I'm going to read this one. When you arrive in Canada, we will assess your health before you leave your port of entry. You must isolate for 14 days even if you don't have a symptoms. This is a mandatory. So mga kap, if you have a work permit, if you have a COPR, if you have a student permit visa, please assess yourself. Make sure, mga kap, that you are healthy and you don't have a symptom of COVID-19. Why? Because if you have a symptoms of the COVID-19, you will not be allowed to enter Canada. Even though you are holding a visa, pero pag may merong kang sintomas, hindi ka papasukin dito sa Canada. So make sure that you're physically healthy, and make sure that you don't have a symptom. So what will happen if you have a symptoms? If you have a symptoms, it says here, you will not be allowed to enter. Pauuwiin ka, sayang ng inyong pamasahe. So if you are asymptomatic, you don't have a symptoms, makakapasok ka ng Canada provided you will isolate or you will do a self-quarantine for 14 days. And says, quote-unquote, says mandatory. They say it's mandatory. So again, mga kap, my best advice for you before we end this video is if you are holding a COPR, student permit visa, or tourist visa, make sure before you travel, make sure that you are physically healthy. Make sure that you don't have a symptoms of COVID-19. Because if you do, hindi ka po papapasukin dito sa Canada at babalik ka sa inyong bansa or sa Pilipinas. So anyway, kap, that's my update for you. I hope this video able to help you. And if you find it informative and helpful, please click the subscribe button. And of course, we have a regular live streaming dito sa When in Halifax YouTube channel every Saturday, 11 morning mga kap, 11 morning Manila time, we have live streaming discussing about Pinoy Canada immigration. So if you have clarifications or you have some information that are not clear to you, join our live streaming with Miss Amelia of Adjuct International. Miss Amelia is my partner here in Wine in Halifax. She is a licensed immigration consultant based here in Alberta, Edmonton, Alberta. Ayan mga kap, that's it. Thank you very much for watching. Don't forget to follow me on Facebook and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you kap, bye-bye. Kita-kita sa Canada!